take a moment today to thank the boldness of our government and our shareholders.
William Hamilton built his venture on the ashes of the Second World War. Copper mine he envisioned was ransacking the First Nation's ancestral territories, drawing the wrath of the local people. It definitely took nerves of steel to stay the course, despite all this hostility. Before long, in the face of William Hamilton's cold and uncompromising stance, the petitions and peaceful protests turned into sabotage, vandalism, and other criminal acts. The industrialists' private properties also encountered the wrath of the demonstrations. Carl Faubert, a veteran of the Korean War, was hired from Montreal as a private detective to shed some light on this whole thing. But at the end of his long journey to northern Quebec, the detective did not only encounter property damage, he also came face to face with the corpse of William Hamilton. The strangeness only kept building throughout the investigation. A powerful, unseasonable blizzard hit the region. Bodies frozen in unbreakable ice appeared. The local fauna began to act strangely and aggressively. Carl Faubert began to doubt his own sanity. The detective felt the weight of a gaze, as if he were at the mercy of a powerful, feral creature waiting for the right moment to attack. Carl's fear was taking over, overpowering his reason. He was giving in to delirium. In that instant, he thought that the dark waters of the lake might shield him from the shapes that pursued him. From there, he had a renewed hope in civilization, or whatever was left of it. Carl knew that on one of these shores stood William Hamilton's lavish mansion, and there the detective had hopes of finding a way out of the area. A phone, a truck, who knows? Under the luxurious paneling and damask carpets, he might be able to find answers to his questions. The detective wondered about the floating debris. Had it drifted out from the shore, or had it been abandoned there in the middle of nowhere? Carl saw a boat in the distance, clearly piloted by one of his own. Had he finally made it to civilization? His hopes were immediately drowned out by the sound of gunshots. Time to flee again, and fast. Swam without a thought, yet each stroke was desperate. The icy water and his wounds made him feel weaker and weaker. He had to get to shore. and the hypothermia were tearing at Carl's poor body. When he finally saw a light in the distance, he was filled with a faint sense of hope. Could it be a refuge? Carl was convinced that he would not wake up if he went to sleep in this state. It was probably best to make a fire and take a look at his wounds.
Так, а где огонь-то у нас? А, вот огонь. Бень второе укрытие.
Carl struggled to wake up. His makeshift bandages offered him little time. If he wanted to find the truth, he had to get to Hamilton Manor without delay. The journal was the rock to hold on to in a rushing waterfall of memories, a tool Carl was happy to have back. The starting point of his investigation was to take inventory of his working tools.
Так, что за рабочие инструменты? В общем, ребят, в первую часть я не играл, поэтому... Поэтому я немножко тут... Не в курсах, чё почём. Вроде начало интересное. Как-нибудь, может, вы мне подсвечивали бы, что ли, предметы? Что за рабочие инструменты? Отличный фотик.
Карл was forgetting the time was running out. He had to go to the manor if he wanted to find the answers to his questions. There was something the detective found charming about the mechanism of the instant cameras.
Carl
left his refuge, knowing that he was headed to a more comfortable, but otherwise ominous place, Hamilton's mansion.
Так, и где этот особняк? Так, туалет типа сортир. Бегаешь, не мерзнешь пока.
He knew that wolves do not attack people. Still, he had to be careful. They say that wolves don't attack humans. Still, Faubert thanked his lucky stars that he was not the man who would prove this theory wrong.
Блин, что-то как-то со стрельбой тут корявенько.
The ice looked recent. Better not test it.
Будем надеяться, волки меня не съедят.
Carl tried to put the horror into perspective. Accidents happen, and in the inhospitable far north, it happens more often than not. Nevertheless, a feeling of déjà vu stayed with him, as if the carnage was not over. The plan suggested that a package had to be retrieved not far away. Carl had to keep his eyes open. This kind of lead-lined bag had only one purpose, to contain the radioactivity of an object. Carl picked it up, hoping with all his soul that he would never need to use it.
Так, порядок оперативных мер.
What were these mysterious fragments? And why was there a warning about the broom? This letter raised more questions than it answered for the detective.
Так, теперь нам надо как-то пройти тут Алчера. Так, сперва, видимо, за ключом надо. Аля, Resident Evil, блин. Mr. Hamilton.
This was the mansion of the late William Hamilton. No doubt about it. There was no other rich industrialist in the area to have a sumptuous mansion built in the middle of nowhere.
Не собирались уезжать. Три никого нет.
Si vous entendez ceci, ce message est crucial. Trouvez un endroit où vous mettre à l'abri. Ne sortez qu'en dernier recours. Si vous avez à sortir, armez-vous et méfiez-vous de quiconque porte les couleurs de la Hamilton Mining Corporation. Tenez-vous le plus loin possible de la faune. Les animaux sont devenus extrêmement agressifs. Je répète, tenez-vous le plus loin possible des animaux et méfiez-vous de quiconque porte les couleurs de la HMC. Si vous entendez ceci, ce message est crucial. Trouvez un endroit où vous mettre à l'abri. Ne sortez qu'en dernier recours. Si vous avez à sortir, armez-vous et méfiez-vous de quiconque porte les couleurs de la Hamilton Mining Corporation. Tenez-vous le plus loin possible de la faune. Les animaux sont devenus extrêmement agressifs. Je répète, tenez-vous le plus loin possible des animaux et méfiez-vous de quiconque porte les couleurs de la Hamilton.
Так, нам надо за ключом.
This letter, found in the cabin, mentioned a gazebo. The key to the mansion would likely be there.
Ну, сейчас посмотрим, где он. Заперто. Стреляет он как-то тут корявенько.
With all this chaos, Carl was sensing a hurried departure.
Миша, блин. Урна Люси. Как-то атмосферно.
Added to the mayhem was violence. Carl understood that a tragedy had occurred here. Carl could not decide which was more frightening, the mysterious impulse the inhabitants had to escape, or the inexplicable way in which their escape was interrupted.
Mm-hmm. Тут и хавчик есть, все есть.
Carl was overcome with a strange emotion. The crossword puzzle was in French, so he guessed it was the work of a Hamilton employee and not Hamilton himself.
Нацкая монетка. Ее типа бросить можно.
From a simple case of vandalism to a mysterious murder, Carl found himself right in the middle of a battlefield. What could possibly await him now?
Интересно, да. Что дальше-то будет? Так, детективный роман. Белых ждет поражение.
Feel his muscles weakening, his breath wheezing, his body going numb. What was happening to him?
Да, блин. Тоже хотелось бы знать, что происходит.
The floor was rocking, The walls seemed to be running from Carl's hands as he tried to steady himself. Something was not right. Carl's thoughts were twisting in his head, making him dizzy.
Тут алкоголем так тут кто-то нормально затарился. Особый ключ.
Carl knew how eccentric older millionaires could be, with more money than they know how to spend it. But never could he have imagined such a sophisticated puzzle.
Так, и что мне тут надо? Как составить? Это из этих, что ли, неправильно? Что тут? А, вот. Подходит. Подходит. Мехико, блин. И тут как-то, а вот похоже так, что ли? А тут не так.
Carl Faubert made a profession out of reconstructing a hole from seemingly incongruous parts. This reconstructed globe forced him to recognize how much more complex the mystery that was currently plaguing Manistan was in comparison.
Я вас понял. А что, не подходит этот ключ-то, что ли? Разбили и пипец.
The material damage now seemed quite benign in the face of everything that had happened since his arrival.
Так, и чё нам записаться? Записались. Непонятно, куда ключ девать.
Hardly find their way in front of him. He doesn't know which way he came from or the way he's going. Everything seems to be going in a circle, a spiral carrying him. He doesn't know where or how. Suddenly feels like he's waking up, but inside the dream.
Ой, мы в дерьме.
The cold hits him suddenly, like a bucket of freezing water. Had he completely lost it, or was he supposed to accept the manor's strange architecture suddenly leading him to the middle of nowhere? These imposing structures seem to come from the depths of time, from the moon landing, or even from his own mind,
climbing after an afternoon nap. Надо их как-то расставить теперь. Вопрос только как.
The detective had no idea how it worked. But the stones seemed to slide on the rails smoothly as soon as the totem pole was rotated.
Так, и что мне с этими тотемами-то делать? Ну? что-то в этом подсказка должна быть. Так, это типа правильно, да? Тоже правильно. Так, красный неправильно. Красные вообще не светятся. Я так понимаю, если правильно ставишь, они светиться должны. Так, этот с ладошкой, это что у нас? Блин, что-то я немного запутался. Положений-то не так много на самом деле, блин. Все равно неверно. Нет, или значит неправильно я понял что-то.
did not know how or why, but Carl sensed that something in this game...
Короче, ладно, разобрались. Короче, братва, вот эта синяя получается ближе к дому. Вот эта, как ее сказать, зеленая, пусть будет. С этим горизонтально завязанным ртом ближе всего. Красная. Вот так. И это, соответственно, здесь с ладошкой.
There was no longer anyone to rescue him from the torrent of hatred that swept away his heart. By a larger force towards the light that was calling him, as if it was asking to be set free. The stone that resonated in the room must have been one of the fragments HMC had been seeking. If he isolated it, Carl hoped he might come to his senses. The pulse of the stone invaded Carl's mind.
What? He
felt a strange, dark presence take shape near him.
Ой, так и должно быть. Не знаю, наверное, да. Пробудись от сновидений. Получим приз. Опять мы в поместье Гамильтона. Так, странный синий камень излучает зловещую энергию. И куда мне его?
Carl could make out some trophies here and there that he had seen earlier in what seemed like a dream.
На волка-то я зря патронов походу потратил. Ну кто же знал-то, я думал. Как-то хоть получше с этим будет.
If Carl had an army of veteran researchers and endless coffee jars at his disposal, he could hope to sift through all these archives, but the circumstances were working against him. The secret was hidden somewhere in the middle of a messy pile of worthless memos.
Так. Что тут, блин? Куда мне эти дрова девать?
Possible to get to the staircase. There had to be another way.
Не, он с дровами ничего не делает абсолютно. Тут карта-то есть. Да нафига я эти дрова подобрал, блин? Как их бросить? Можно их как-то бросить? Так, где тут прочие документы? А, вот снизу показано. 9 батареек у меня. Так, ну чё, вроде как Resident Evil, а-ля, достаточно атмосферно. В общем, здесь серию закончим. В принципе, игрушку-то, я думаю, даже, ну, как бы, пройду. Достаточно очень атмосферно в наушниках, напоминает этот Resident Evil в переосмыслении, где вид от первого лица. Больше-то эту часть в особняке, где ходить. В общем, лайки, подписки, ссылки в описании. Играли по подписке на другие мои ресурсы. Подписывайтесь, также ссылки в описании. Играли мы по подписке Game Pass через облачный сервис xCloud от Microsoft. В общем, на этом все. Всем пока, увидимся.